When we were first thinking about arranging this, we thought, wow, you know, boxing, fisticuffs, fighting, so un-Hong Kong, it'll be a real change. That was before Occupy Central. So who knew? Today, we have someone very special. The first professional boxer from Hong Kong. First means first ever, to use that redundancy. His family has boxing in the blood. His father was a 7-time champion amateur boxer. His brother was a champion, let me see if I've got that down here, 4 times in a different weight. His father was, your father was super fly or flyweight? Flyweight in it, okay. And his brother was in the a larger weight category, a bantamweight. Rex Tso just told me that he was one of those kids who just didn't like studying. You know, put the head on the pillow, avoid the books. But boxing has completely turned him around. Among other things, it's how he's learned to speak some English. But today he's going to be assisted in that department by Ken Ho, who's a co-manager and co-promoter. And I should also, wherever he is in the room, introduce Jay Lau. Where are you, Jay? Who's the head coach and Hong Kong's first boxing promoter, who's taken a huge risk when you consider that there was no boxing except for some amateur boxing and some people taking classes at universities. And he took the risk to create something totally new, and that involved finding a boxer and creating a gym. And that's a very interesting story in and of itself. So good on you, Jay. Ken is going to assist us. Ken is a Vancouverite, and he's going to assist today because although Rex has managed to teach himself, I can say, quite good English boxing in the ring, he would like his manager to help him out, and he'll be doing some sequential translation. And then afterwards, we'll open it up to questions. So without further ado and boring you with details like the fact that he's 15-0 record with 9 knockouts, let's bring up Rex Tso. Rex.
Hello, everyone. Hi, 大家好. Hi, 我是 Rex Tso. 我是 我是 香港的第一位職業拳手. 我是 現在的成績是 15場比賽全勝的, 是有 9次 KO.
Hi, I'm Rex. Thank you for having me here. And as Francis mentioned, I have a pro record of 15-0 with 9 knockouts.
我最初一開始點解會接觸拳擊嘅時候，其實係因為我屋企人佢係打拳啦。咁我細個嘅時候，大約5至6歲左右，我爸爸就已經會教我 boxing 嘅最基本嘅點樣企啊，點樣出拳咁樣。
So I first got into boxing around 5 or 6 years old. With my family background in boxing, I started to learn the fundamentals, the basics, with my father, 5 or 6 years old, very young age.
但係當時其實自己就唔係好鍾意呢個運動，因為運動本身你要有好成績就一定要好辛苦咁去訓練啦。咁細個嘅我嘅時候就會好怕辛苦嘅。
But I didn't like it at all. Because to do well at anything, you really have to practice. It involves hardship. And kids don't like hardship.
一直到讀書啦，我其實都有，因為屋企人嘅關係，呢個拳擊就變咗我嘅家庭運動。 人哋嘅家庭運動係籃球，我就變咗係拳擊咁樣，都會有一直都有參與呢樣運動，咁但係就唔係全心去訓練啦。咁就算去到16歲參加業餘嘅比賽嘅時候，都會有去比賽，但係只係有比賽我去試下啦咁。
So academics wasn't a strong point, a strong, his family is not an academic family, but it is a boxing family. So, but unfortunately, I didn't have the attitude to do well. So, but I did compete in amateur contests when I was about 16.
一直喺业余嘅比赛，其实自己都冇认真去训练好自己啦。咁喺比赛嘅时候，就算比赛赢咗，我都系赢得非常之辛苦嘅。输咗，我就靠自己嘅天才波去赢，即系去打。咁就算输，但系都好精彩嘅比赛咁样。
I had a mixed record as an amateur. And even when I won, it was through a lot of effort, and it was close. But when I lost, it was... It was through his innate talent and definitely not effort.
咁到讀完書之後啦，咁自己其實就唔中意讀書嘅，咁。 翻學都係掛住玩啊、瞓覺啊咁樣，所以就因為唔知道讀書究竟對我將來有咩幫助，咁所以就冇諗過去讀書。
But as for school, I was really lazy. I kept sleeping at school, playing around, and frankly, had no idea what education could offer in terms of career and future.
咁到。 讀完書之後，又喺屋企幾個月都未有嘢做，咁都要揾嘢做，要為生活諗下啦，咁都要揾工，咁就揾咗啲朋友介紹咗啲倉務啊、跟車嘅工作俾我去試做咁樣。So
after graduation, after finishing school, Rex was unemployed for several months, and finally he did get a job, but as a courier. Courier, mover?
Yeah, a cargo guy. 咁當時就我嘅教練阿J啦，咁其實由細到大佢都識我嘅，因為阿J其實就係我爸爸嘅徒弟嚟嘅。咁佢就聽到啊，阿Rex竟然咁，因為我以前嘅身形比而家仲更加細粒，更加。
But at the time, he ran into Jay. Jay, who has known Rex all of his life, because Rex's father was actually Jay's coach. So when Jay found out that Rex is a mover, moving heavy cargo, but this was a guy, Rex was actually even skinnier back then than he is now, and he wondered, how can this guy make a living?
咁當時我嘅哥哥亦都喺阿J開嘅拳館入邊做教練啦，咁就同哥哥講，不如你叫你細佬入嚟一齊做教練啦，咁起碼。
So Jay had already hired Rex's older brother, Ralph, to be a coach at his gym. So one day Jay asked Ralph, hey, why don't you ask your brother to be a coach here too? You might have a better future.
咁當時我就開始入咗拳館度做part-time嘅教練啦。咁最初入去做教練嘅時候就直頭。 英文都唔識，因為以前冇讀書啦，咁要教學生外國嘅學生打拳，咁就要用身體語言啊，要喐佢隻手啊，喐佢隻腳咁樣嚟教嗰啲學生。So
Rex started to coach at our gym, and it was a bit tricky because he was so bad at school, he didn't learn English, but he had to teach foreigners. So, at first, it started off with body language.
但係跟教啲其他嘅學生嘅時候，有啲人就會即係望到我嘅身形啊，你咁細咁細粒，
Some of the students, when they saw him, they had a look in their eye that suggested, this skinny guy, this tiny guy, you're going to coach me?
經過有幾次都係咁樣經驗嘅時候，其實我都覺得自己都要做好啲自己，咁樣嚟等教人嘅時候都會有啲說服力啦。咁嗰陣時，阿J又當時又巧合地又想搞職業嘅比賽啦。咁喺嗰陣時，阿J就開始train我做職業嘅打法啦。So
this motivated Rex to do better, to train harder and take things more seriously, or to be more convincing as a coach. And after a while, the head coach, Jay, had a vision to bring professional boxing to Hong Kong. And so he started to train Rex.
跟阿J去訓練嘅時候，自己開頭其實都唔清楚自己得唔得嘅，因為都係覺得好辛苦，未接觸過咁辛苦嘅訓練。咁但係我又覺得即係阿J搞職業比賽，都自己又其實都想試，又有咁嘅咁難得嘅機會，即係唔試可能之後會後悔咁樣。
So Rex did try it out. He did try to train harder, but he found it difficult. And you know, this guy doesn't like hardship. But and not only that, he didn't see any results. Well, he did start, I'll add this, he did start to win all of his fights in Hong Kong under Jay. The training was a lot more effective. But other than that, you don't see money, right?
當時就阿J就搞第一次嘅職業嘅拳擊比賽啦，喺香港度搞。咁當時我就因為為呢個比賽訓練，就去咗菲律賓嗰度集訓啦，就訓練咗一個月。咁開頭其實都唔知自己究竟得唔得嘅，因為一直 喺自己嘅心入邊都係覺得自己其實都仍然係好懶惰，好基本功好差嘅。咁就去到菲律賓嘅時候就，其實去菲律賓之前咧，阿J亦都有講過話，你嘅基本功咁差，你唔練好啲你嘅體能，你去到菲律賓嗰度個教練係唔會教你嘅。你見你咁差，佢可能第一日就會講你走咁樣。So
Rex was sent to the Philippines, and before he went to the Philippines, head coach Jay told him, your fundamentals are not great, your stamina, your fitness is not great. You know, if you disappoint your coach there, he may even kick you out on the first day.
咁喺去菲律賓之前，其實已經自己就一路喺度驚緊，我要點樣先可以追得翻呢個 職業嘅水平咧，咁自己一路驚一路就耷低頭，係咁訓練去諗住追翻以前同而家嘅差距咁樣，咁就搏命咁去訓練自己嘅體能，希望去到菲律賓嘅時候，教練可以教我嘅技術啦咁樣。So
worrying about this and being motivated by this, Rex really put in a lot more effort just to get to the next step.
咁當去到菲律賓嘅時候， 仍然都係擔心緊，但係就一路教練教我嘅嘢，我就盡量去學習啦。繼續雖然係辛苦啦，咁但係自己就會覺得係，就算幾咁辛苦，都會有一定嘅得著嘅，即係會有得益，係咯。So
yeah, he kept training and with the idea in mind that the effort, the results will come.
咁之後到訓練完一個月嘅時候，翻到香港 去參加第一次嘅職業比賽。因為經過一個月真係全程去認真咁樣去訓練嘅時候，其實自己嘅心情比以前係完全唔同曬。以前業餘嘅時候參加比賽前就會瞓唔著覺，跟住去到比賽嘅場地嘅時候就會驚緊呢樣驚嗰樣，驚對手好犀利，驚對手好大隻好大力，驚自己會冇體能冇氣，驚好多樣嘢嘅。咁但係到真係完全付出去訓練嘅時候，到第一次職業比賽嘅時候係非常之期待個比賽，係好想去好想去將嗰一個月訓練嘅嘢去發揮出嚟啦，去表達俾所有觀眾睇。
So after 1 month of training in the Philippines, Rex came back for his professional debut, and things were very different. I mean, that 1 month of training really changed him. That 1 month of intensive training, of only training, when he fought in amateur contests, he'd be nervous and he wouldn't be able to fall asleep the night before. He'd be worried about the fight, worried about how strong his opponent would be. But then, coming back from the Philippines, he was actually more focused because he knew that with 1 month of training behind him, he could go in there in a more assured manner.
當上到比賽場嘅時候，其實即係你未同對手打過，你都唔會知道贏定輸啦。咁上到擂台嘅時候，都係想盡量發揮好自己。咁當真係將學過嘅嘢全部發揮出嚟嘅時候，其實個效果係幾好，即係可以壓制住個對手嚟打嗰場比賽啦。咁嗰場其實係4個回合嘅比賽，我都可以發揮得幾好咁樣去壓住全個比賽，壓住對手嚟打咁樣，到最後係贏咗嗰場比賽啦。咁嗰次贏咗係我人生以嚟第一次有咁多人去認同我，係。
So even when Rex got into the ring, he had no idea how things would go. But as the fight started, Rex actually put pressure on his opponent. He put all of the work that he put into training for that 1 month into action. And it was effective. He put pressure on his opponent for the entire four rounds of the fight. And he emerged victorious. Not only that, but that was the first time in his life that after the win, or actually during the fight and after the win, the entire crowd was behind him.
係全場300人一齊企起身拍手掌認同我。
Everyone was standing up, clapping, yelling his name, and just getting behind him.
由嗰刻開始，我真係覺得揀呢條路係真係冇錯。即係就算之後幾咁辛苦，就算即係中途冇錢都好，即係因為之後有幾場比賽就唔係喺香港度打比賽啦，就去咗菲律賓嗰度就打比賽。咁就算冇錢都好，但係即係有人哋認同我嗰個感覺係用錢係買唔到。
So it was at that moment that Rex knew that this was the right path. Even if there would be moments when there would be no money, it's the right path. And in fact, he did fight in the Philippines several times for little to no pay.
由嗰陣時開始，我就真係將所有嘅時間都放曬入去拳擊呢度。咁以前我就由一日可能全部時間放曬喺打機度，日日坐喺度十幾個鐘頭，變咗而家一日可能去到8個鐘頭喺拳擊度。咁係將我嘅人生好大嘅改變啦，就將我嘅壞習慣都去除咗啦，亦都令到我自己嘅健康又多咗好多啦，好咗好多啦。
So it was from that moment that Rex got rid of all of his bad habits. Before, he would spend really a dozen hours a day playing video games. But since then, he stopped. He doesn't play anymore. And he actually trains 8 hours a day. Got rid of all his bad habits, and he's got a lot more focus now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, can I just ask Jay Lau, the head coach, to come up, just in case anyone asks questions about training, his training or diet regimen.
Microphone closer there, and yeah. All right, so we've got some questions and answer time here. I just want to say that he referred to little or no money. His first professional fight, he earned $100 US. It's a long climb up, and he's looking forward to a possible shot in the middle of the summer for a title fight. So maybe some you can tell us a little bit about that fight and who you might be fighting and where.
Like, 希望挑戰的對手會是日本的選手叫 Carno. Yeah.
So for the world title fight, tentatively scheduled for June or July, Rex's opponent, we're looking at a Japanese champion named Carno.
And that would be super flyweight or a different weight class?
Yeah, super flyweight.
Super flyweight. Let's open this to questions from the floor. First hand I see is right over here. Please wait for a microphone and identify yourself, please.
Hi, my name is Nikhil Epen. So I have a question. You elaborated on this, so I apologize for going back to the point. But you were a mediocre amateur fighter, right? And then suddenly, and now after a lot that has happened, a lot of training, you're not just a mediocre professional boxer, you're a championship contender. So how does that step change happen? It's mind-boggling. You talked about it was training focused, but I'd love to hear a little bit more detail from you and then also from the coach's perspective. Because how you go through so many levels in such a short period of time.
Actually, 就冇认真咁去放投放时间去训练，咁但系当第一次听到职业呢个字嘅时候，我唔知道自己究竟要付出几多，同埋唔知道自己同职业差距几远，其实系因为惊，所以先至会放好多时间落去谂住提升自己去参加比赛。
Rex's mediocre amateur days can be attributed to his laziness. But as soon as he heard the word professional, fear took over. And it was because of fear that he put effort into training and took boxing a lot more seriously. So it was through that effort and the training that he was able to better fulfill his potential and achieve better results.
So actually, Rex turned pro for since 2011. Okay, he's been turning professional boxing from now for 40 months. In the last 36 months, he's training two times harder than normal boxers. Why of that? Because he know he start late. Actually, for Rex, he's now 27 years old. He turned pro when he was 24. And If you are in a professional boxing, you know, like Canelo from Mexico, he has two world title belts when he was 19. So what I tell Rex is, if you read a book called 10,000 Hours, you'll be a professional. You'll be a world class. That's what I tell him. And now calculate that. How many hours you've been really spending effort on your boxing in your childhood? I put probably like 50 hours, that's it. For your whole 16 years of boxing, amateur, you're not putting any effort on it. So actually you are like a brand new boxer, but now the chance is here. So he know it, he understand, and he just changed from laziness to really working really hard. And one of the most harder things for Rex, most harder thing that Rex can improve than other people is not just because of his training. Even though when he's training in Philippines, he trained 8 hours a day, but after that, like 6 p.m., that's it, and he got to go rest. Most of the guys after the training, they go, oh, hang out with the friends, they play video games. You know, for Rex, he only rests. 6 p.m., dinner, after that, his entertainment will be watching sunset for 30 seconds. And then he will WhatsApp his girlfriend for another 2 minutes. Okay, nice out, rest. You rest for 12 hours, good sleep, you wake up at 5 in the morning, sorry, in the 10 hours, and you wake up at 5 in the morning, and you get your ass go to run for 1.5 hours. So he actually spent double effort to pick up what he lost. Okay, it is danger because the human being has a, you know, when you hit the top, that's the top. So actually Rex have suffered of other things, is the injury in his of the body, as the legs, you know, but he get used to it and keep going. So that's how I hope he can answer your questions.
Let me insert one thing. Rex may be the first boxing champion from Hong Kong to come along, but he's not the first championship boxer to speak at the FCC. He's the second. The first one was named Muhammad Ali. And a signed picture of him is, as you exit downstairs at the bottom of the stairs, take a look on the wall, and there's a picture signed by him speaking at the FCC before. So you're in good company, Rex. I saw Eric Wishart's hand over here. Please wait for the microphone, Eric.
Hi. Hello, I'm Eric Wishart. I work for AFP News Agency. I've followed boxing since the Muhammad Ali days, so go back a long way with it. One thing that you talked about, the physical training side, one thing that always fascinates me about boxing is the psychological side. So I watch you standing, smiling. You're a very friendly young man. What can you explain to us what happens when you step in the ring? What happens? What's your, from the start, with the opponent, how do you try to out-psych the opponent? And how do you transform from the nice young man here to the guy that wants to knock the other guy out? What's the mindset?
When I go to the fight, 自己就要培養情緒去迎接接下來將會的比賽。當時其實是會全部東西都不想，只是會想一會兒比賽會做些什麼，人家打來我要怎樣去反應，還有不停地重複想之前訓練過幾個月的訓練過的東西，要在一會兒的比賽中運用出來。所以其實 自己那一刻的樣子其實是很集中在想著比賽。
Rex is usually smiling, but right before every fight, he's able to clear his mind and really focus on what's to come. He's going to focus on what he will do in the ring. And so if you look at him, the smile's gone.
盡量去發揮好自己，在比賽開始的時候，是會分析對方的距離感，他打的力度，我可不可以承受到，是分析比賽。Then
as soon as he gets into the ring, it's all about focus. He's doing things like measuring the distance between himself and his opponent, and he's really analyzing every moment. So it's really the epitome of focus.
I know we have one or two more questions here. I just want to say that because we have sequential translation and a lot of interest, we're going to go a couple of minutes, a couple of minutes longer. Nani, I'll give you the last question, Nani. Can you hold on? Great. This lady out here, please wait for the microphone and identify yourself, please. I want to just say, by the way, to everybody, we do tape these. We put them up on YouTube. You can come back and look at them later, but it's important that you speak into the mic so that people can hear the question when they tune into YouTube. Thank you.
My name is Jane Hong. Following on from what you just said, so what's your emotion, you know, if you had to analyze what your emotion is, and what makes a good boxer? That's...
首先係要好集中去訓練自己啦，去將自己唔好嘅缺點揾出嚟去改善，同埋真係每次訓練嘅時候要好認真咁樣去投入個訓練度啦。咁同埋喺比賽嘅時候真係要。自己要做啲乜嘢咯？同埋喺比賽嘅時候，好多人都會問你個樣咁樣，其實你係咪嬲嘅對手？其實喺比賽嘅時候係唔會嬲嘅對手，因為你一嬲嘅時候，你會成個思想會都會唔清晰，分析唔到對方做啲乜。 所以其實喺比賽嘅時候係要保持得非常冷靜咁樣去打一場比賽。
So about the emotions when he goes into the ring, that's a very good question. A lot of people ask him, how does he feel? What are your emotions when you get into the ring? And they ask, are you angry? And Rex says that actually he's not angry. It's despite the angry look on his face. He's actually calm. He's calm because he needs to be calm. Because if you're not calm, going into a fight, you lose focus, you can't concentrate, you can't do what you need to do. So he's actually very calm. As for your question about what makes a good boxer, focus is the main thing. Because a lot of people, they try to be boxers, they try to do other sports, but what they lack is focus, and they find excuses for themselves to not do the hard work that really needs to go into it.
Do we have another question out here from the floor? Yes, one over here. Please wait for the mic.
I'm just wondering, Neil Taylor. I'm just wondering, how do you see Hong Kong developing as a center for boxing? If it will ever develop? I mean, there's a lot of money going right now into developing the sport in China. And as you know, because I've seen you fight in Macau a couple of times, which was brilliant. Macau is becoming a major location for fights, professional fights. Does Hong Kong have any kind of future?
These questions go to me. No, boxer don't care about that. It's a very good question. I've been doing 4 professional boxing events in Hong Kong. I actually bring Ricky Hatton to Hong Kong too. But each fight I lost money. The thing is, it's hard to get the sponsorships to do a boxing event in Hong Kong. But I believe we will eventually make it because when Rex turned into be a world champion, I'm sure the boxing in Hong Kong will be changed. Now, this moment here, we are trying on it. Maybe you could ask me the question again after next year. Thank you.
I can remember when Hong Kong had a velodrome and they tore it down, saying that bicycling was a sport in which Hong Kong would never be any good. They now want to build another velodrome because Hong Kong has won a gold medal in cycling. So who knows what comes next? Nanhee, I see your hand
up. I got 2 questions, actually. Who are your role models? Because there were no Hong Kong major boxers when you were starting out. Like, who did you look up to? And secondly, the world title fight next year in the summer, that's going to be a much tougher fight. I mean, what's the training regimen? How are you going to prepare? Because it's not going to be like the fights you did before.
Manny Pacquiao 啦, 因為首先他也是左右，所以我在他身上也可以學到很多技術上的知識。另外就是因為他可以打到八個級別的世界冠軍，影響到整個菲律賓都很大的轉變，全部人都要學 boxing 咁樣。 其實我都好希望有一日我可以有咁嘅影響力啦，同埋亦都自己好希望真係喺世界嘅拳壇入邊，真係可以將香港放喺入邊，令到即係其他地方嘅人都知道，原來香港都有 boxing。
To answer your first question, Rex's role model and idol is Manny Pacquiao. Because he's an 8 division champion, and like Rex, he is a southpaw, that is left-handed. And more importantly, with his amazing career, Manny Pacquiao has inspired the entire country of the Philippines. Everybody in the Philippines, well, not everybody, but a lot of people in the Philippines want to become a boxer because of Manny Pacquiao, and they all get behind him. And this influence, Rex hopes to achieve this influence. He hopes he can develop boxing through his own success. And there'll be more boxers, more people taking up boxing here too.
And the training for the next fight.
另外在训练方面就，啊，你，肥急急下阿J。Boxers cannot be always stay at the peak. This is very dangerous. Rex just finished his fight 2 weeks ago, so he will have a 1 month break, a whole full 1 month break. This is the first long break he ever had in that 14 months. So, and he will start training again in the mid January, and then his eliminator fight will be at 8th of March. In Venetians. If he win the eliminator fight, and then he will have a chance to challenge the world champion. So he will have a 2 months training before the fight. We start at mid-January.
Can you tell us a little bit more about that fight, who the opponent will be, and the exact location?
The location will be at the Cotai Arena in Venetians Hotel. The opponent is still sinking. We are still speaking with top rank because both four divisions, four associations, including WBC, WBA, IBF, and WBO, they are all waving hand to Rex. They want Rex to fight his title. So we are still looking for, but majorly we're interested to fight with WBA world title, who is the world champion now is named Kuno, and he will defend his title at the 30th of December in Japan. And I went there and especially meet the promoter and speak with him.
I'll give the floor one more chance, and then otherwise we just wrap it up with a warm applause. Any last questions out here? No? No? All right. In that case, Rex Tso, thank you very much. Ken, thank you very much. And we'll see you all at the next event. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. We have a gift. We never let anybody go empty-handed. I do have a gift. There you go. Thank you very much. I think somebody got a photo. Thank you very much. There you go.